All that remains now is to announce the top 20 teams in each division and the additional qualifiers. But as you can see behind me on screen, one more time before this night is done, we must thank the teachers of the World Scholars Cup. They have demonstrated leadership, they have demonstrated love and patience, even when ceremonies run a little too long. Thank you all so much for all you do. You don't know how much we have missed you this year. Now, not in this theater with us tonight, because of capacity restrictions, although many of them are hiding along the sidelines, are the families of the World Scholars Cup. Scholars, there's two different kinds of families that we need to think about. There is a family that will welcome you home tonight or when you return to your city. The family that will celebrate your achievements, that will motivate you in difficult moments, and celebrate with you at the best of times. Family has been more important than ever this last year or two all over the world. I'm so grateful to your families for supporting you here with us tonight. But there is another kind of family out there, and that is the family that you find, the family that you choose, the family that stays with you for the rest of your life once you have been so fortunate as to discover them. We would like to thank two members of the World Scholars Cup family who have been here with us for well over a decade, who started the program in China at my side. In a year that has been about separation, for me, one of the sweetest joys of this round has been this reunion. So thank you, Zach. Thank you, Grace. And I appreciate that you still let the scholars set your hair on fire. I know that logistical issues also sometimes set your hair on fire. And Grace, thank you. We would also like to thank the Chinese health authorities, because they have allowed me to come to China, and I am so grateful to them for that, despite all the nose and throat swabs and the time spent alone with Cat TV. Thank you. And to make an event like this run, you don't just need a team that is part of your program all the time. You need a group of people who join you just for the occasion. They volunteer their time, their heart, their hard work. So please join me in applauding the volunteers who have been here with us all week. And will still be here tomorrow, finishing, cleaning up, working with us as if they were our team. And speaking of working with us as if they were our team, I have looked behind me many times at this awards ceremony and felt disoriented because I have never been to an awards ceremony at a global round without the World Scholars Cup staff there at my side and on the stage. Yet we are so lucky to have here in China the great team of ASDAN. They have filled us with joy, much like this puppy I saw the other day as I walked by a barber shop in Jiading. I also just ran out of photos to use. And at ASDAN, there's been no one who has believed more in the World Scholars Cup than Yichan, who was here at the very beginning. Yichan, if you could join us on stage, please, you belong here with us. The very first time I met her, she came to find me at a mall in Beijing to learn about the World Scholars Cup. Soon, of course, I was parking her car, but little did I know that she would be the one navigating our program here in China. Thank you, Yichan. And she has been asking me for an alpaca pin. No one in this theater deserves it more this year. Of course, we've also been fortunate to have so much of the World Scholars Cup team helping us even from afar, writing the questions, reading the essays, planning the logistics of this event, answering every question possible, recording things that sometimes worked and sometimes didn't. I am so sad that they are not here, and yet they have never felt truly absent, thanks to Telegram and a little Zoom. So scholars, they won't know it, but if you could join me in applauding the entire World Scholars Cup team that could not be here in Shanghai this season. They have worked so hard on this event, especially in faraway time zones. And the most important group to thank in this theater. Let me put it this way. A year ago today, I was alone in a corner of London Heathrow Airport. I was alone because there was no global round and because I didn't know where to go to find the scholars of the World Scholars Cup. You are this program. Even those of you who are leaving because we're running late, we understand. And really, you fill our lives with purpose. The clinking of the medals around your necks is what gives us joy. So thank you for allowing me to be here with you. I didn't get to meet every one of you, but I hope to someday. And we must thank Alex. I'm still not sure exactly what we're thanking you for, but I am excited for you. And now our top 20 champion teams. These teams, of course, qualify for Yale. In 20th place, in the junior division, and also your 7th place team in the Northern Region, Western Academy of Beijing, team 769. Please come forward for your gold medals and trophy. Yes. And in the senior division, from Beijing Academy, and also your sixth place team in the North, team 822. In 19th, and ninth place in the East, it is Concordia Shanghai, team 169. And in the senior division, Shanghai High School International Division, 937. In 18th in junior and 8th in the East, Shanghai High School International Division, team 716. And in senior, a mixed team from Suzhou, team 970. Trophy and medals. In 17th and 4th place in the South, it is a mixed team from the Shenzhen area, team 709. In 17th and senior, ISB, team 885. In 16th and 7th in the East, Shanghai Jinsai, team 723. In 16th place in the senior division, maybe the junior. I've lost. Ah, yes, senior. Very good. And fourth place in the North, Beijing Academy, 823. 15th place junior, Dulwich Beijing, team 181. 15th and senior, Beijing World Youth Academy, 841. 14th and junior, Beijing SMIC, 141. 14th senior, Shanghai Pudong / Harrow, 935. In 13th place, from Fudan International School, team 185. In 13th place, from Concordia International, team 849. In 12th, from Basis Hangzhou, team 106. In senior, from Nanjing Foreign Language School, 905. In 11th place in the junior division, from Basis Park Lane Harbor, team 114. And in senior, Nanjing Foreign Language Pinghai Shanghai, team 907. In 10th place, in the junior division, Western Academy of Beijing, 773. Uh-oh, we have a broom. Or did we give away the broom? Hazard on stage. In 10th place, in the senior division, what could possibly go wrong? From Dulwich College, Beijing, team 853. In 9th place in the junior division, from Beijing World Youth Academy, team 164. In 9th place in the senior division, from Chengdu Shude / Hun School of Princeton. That's a very interesting school name. It is team 996. And 8th place in the junior division, from Shanghai High School International Division, it is team 715. In 8th place in the senior division, from Chinese International Hangzhou, it is team 848. In 7th, in junior, from Basis Guangzhou, team 101. In 7th place in the senior division, from Basis Hangzhou, team 821. In sixth place in the junior division, from Keystone Academy, team 627. And in sixth place in the senior division, from Shenzhen College of International Education, it is team 959. Only five teams remain in addition to the additional qualifiers. But I should not be the one to announce them. To announce the top five teams at this round, it is only right to hand the podium over to our Alpaca of the Year. The Alpaca of the Year at the World Scholars Cup is a special honor given to members of our team at our global rounds. This particular member of our team has been with us since 2015. There were times when our own staff forgot to appreciate what a difference she was making over the years, and yet steadily, one year at a time, she became a core member of our team and one who stepped forward when only two members of our team could come to China and run the rounds that you've all been at. I can take the medal, yes? Of course. Thank you so much. Now I have a medal to give her. It says something that when the pandemic hit and at the World Scholars Cup, we no longer had rounds and we no longer had revenue, that Min stepped forward and said that she would keep working and wouldn't need to be paid. Like, we haven't given Min, I don't know why sometimes you give so much to this program, but I promise you that will change. Look at this theater. There are students here because you were here, and there's empty seats that were filled because they were here, but we ran long. Min, thank you for making me your uncle. I know there will come a time when maybe you aren't with us in the way you are now, but I hope we can stay related and that we can share this stage many, many times to come. Before you announce the awards, I have to make sure your name appears on screen. And I want to give you the microphone.
Daniel has asked me to say a few words, but I'm pretty sure I will cry if I say much more. So without further ado, shall we go into our top teams?
Actually, before we announce the top teams, we have a second Alpaca of the Year. Who could it be? I will admit that this is the member of our team that I least expected to be here today. When he first joined us, he asked if he could take pictures at our round in Kazakhstan. And suddenly, he is running half our program in China. I don't know where he went. He's hiding over there. Riding motorbikes, renting apartments, dating people. Doug, I am so grateful to you. I do really miss your pictures. My Telegram chat has had you misspelled all year. Sorry. Study of mistake.
have a new last name. I now have a new last name.
Lam.
Lam Yen Shun.
Douglas had a little lamb.
Douglas have a little lamb? Okay.
In our junior division, in fifth place, joining us from Shanghai American School, Puxi, it is Team 712.
Our fifth place senior. Also the fourth place in the East. Joins us from a school in, well, I don't know where the school is, but joins us from Fudan International School. Let's welcome to the stage Team 858.
In the junior division, fourth place, also winning first place in the Southern office, it is International School of Nanshan Shenzhen and Basis International School Shenzhen, Team 804.
And our fourth place senior team, also winning the third place trophy in the eastern part of China. This team joins us from a school in Shanghai. This school is Concordia International School, Shanghai. It is Team 850.
In the third place of the junior division, also placing first in the northern office, therefore coming to us from Beijing, it is International School of Beijing, Team 624.
And scholars, our third place senior team, placing second in the eastern part of China. This school joins us from Shanghai. This school is Shanghai United International School, Gubei. Let's welcome to the stage Team 952.
In second place of the junior division, also placing second in the eastern office, from a school not in Shanghai, Basis International School, Hangzhou, Team 109.
And scholars, our second place senior team, also the first, the champion team in the northern part of China. This team joins us from a, well, this school joins us from a city in China. In Beijing, from Dulwich College, Beijing, let's welcome Team 854.
the junior division for 2021 Not Quite Global Round in Shanghai. It is a school in Shanghai winning first place in the Eastern Office from Shanghai United International School, Gubei. It is team 729.
Perfect timing. Which leaves us with one final trophy. Well, there are multiple trophies that have not been redeemed yet, but that is another story. But the final trophy we'll be giving out tonight is our overall champion team in the senior division in this Not Quite Global Round in Shanghai. Our first place senior team, also winning first place in the eastern part of China. This school is from Shanghai. And I was in the Shanghai regional round and we were doing awards. And I got booed during the regional round because I was reading this school's name wrong. And I was corrected quite a lot. This school, scholars, is Shanghai Din Tai High School International Division. It is team 941. Trophies, pineapples, and delayed confetti. And scholars, those are all the trophies and medals we will be giving out today. However, we have something known as additional qualifiers. These are teams who have qualified for the Tournament of Champions, not based on your ranking, but because you scored over a global threshold. You will not be receiving any awards, so please celebrate in your seats with your chairs and your teammates. But instead, you'll be winning yourself qualification for the Tournament of Champions event. So scholars, are you ready to find out who the additional qualifiers are? Scholars, here are your additional qualifiers.
Thank you. only one thing for me to draw. Cause we are in global round. Draw me an alpaca.
Okay.
What is that? So ugly there.
This is the not quite alpaca in the not quite global round.
Okay.